Let's look at a chart here real quick that shows latencies. And Yury, I'm going to let you take first run on this one, and I'll come back and add some commentary.
So that was a bit surprising for me, yet not so much because, it's an ongoing discussion what people mean by the low latency, ultra low latency, or whatever. And we see that perception here. It's like everything at once. So from our experience, the top notch ultra low latency is worth in two cases. So first one is real-time communication, which is obviously not part of traditional delivery and it's not covered by this survey in any case. And the second one would be concerned with betting, bidding, and everything around that, because that requires the real low latency, real quick reaction to the events. And so per our experience, it's feasible to create a one-to-many media delivery pipeline, which is what the streaming is all about, in low hundreds of milliseconds. It's feasible, like 200 milliseconds, 300 milliseconds. But the question is, are you ready to pay for that? That's the key question, because every split of a second you go down latency with latency reduction will cost you progressively more when you're building those delivery systems. So that question is really important. So the question that you asked in the survey is, what is your perception? What do you want? What is it that you consider low latency? If the answer is like more than 2 seconds, which is like 22%, okay, fine, you can use low latency HLS. Like, this is what it was created for, in the first place for. If you need 250 and below, well, let's look at the WebRTC and fine-tuned pipelines specifically for that use case. If that's in between, well, you should choose. It's up to you, but you need to remember that the lower you go in the latency, the more you will pay for that.